First of all, thank you very much for Mr. Arif providing us this beautiful opportunity, and thank you for Istanbul Ticaret University for locating us this beautiful place. My name is Ufuk Eriş. I'm from Anadolu University. I'm working there for 15 years as an assistant professor in Communication Sciences Faculty, Communication Design and Management Department. And my presentation is about what they talk about hacktivism in Twitter. So I cooperate with a company. I used their tools to get the information, and I will share those information with you now. I know that you're all tired, but I'm educated with 3S about the conferences. Those S: stand up, speak up, shut up. So I will obey the rules. It will be very short. Okay, so most of my presentation is in Turkish. I expected there will be Turkish audience, so they would understand from presentation, but I will talk in English, I expect. But anyway, first of all, I thought that I must give you some general information about the situation of Twitter in Turkey. You know, but you can see, I will not, I will keep it short, I will not talk about all these percentages. You can see that about gender, age, marital status, take part in shopping decisions, yeah, I mean Twitter's effect, children in the house, and education level. As you see, the university is the first education level as a percentage. In Turkey, who use Twitter? This chart talks about that. So the other one is about shopping. Their interests, the most internet websites, science and technology, films, movies, music, books, reading, photography. Existence of something is meaningful, but non-existence of something is much more significant to me. There is no politics here, as you see. It is very important for my topic. Why does it? They use social networking services. They upload photos online, check information on leisure and entertainment, and for a product or service to buy, as you see. They still watch TV every day. 96% of Twitter users watch television every day. So this traditional media is still an effective channel in Turkey for Twitter users. Special days, these are tweets for each special day. You can see that Republic Day is the day most tweeted time. And why they follow brands on Twitter, the Twitter users, to get updates on future products. So mostly technology, especially new technology, is main reason for them to follow Twitter. Twitter active users interact with five key verticals. You can see that the most one is this with 95 percent. And after that, the purchase offline, as you can see. It's a general view of Turkish internet users. Twitter user population who talk in Turkish is 3 million in Turkey, and daily the average number of tweets is 12 million every day. Now I searched for tweets that includes hacktivism or hacktivist. There were only 2,358 tweets in 12 million tweets. So it's really tells something about hacktivism in Twitter users. They don't talk about it. The most used hashtags are Red Hack, Tango Down, and it's in Turkish. I can translate it as Iran executes the Kurds, Kurdish people. These hashtags and their tweets that they get. And they're all social problems. Red Hack especially is another important word for me to search. There's only 54 tweets on hacktivist hashtag and anonymous. So I thought that they don't know about hacktivism or hacktivist. They don't use this word, but they use some the names of those groups, Red Hack and Anonymous. Hacktivism. And the users most mentioned about this topic, those users mostly mentioned, but 1,162 tweets only mentioned of those users. The Red Hack, of course, Red Hack editor. Do you know about the Red Hack? It's a hacktivist group in Turkey. And those are the users mentioned most. You can see cold hackers. And the most tweeted users about hacktivism and hacktivists, these are individual users, you can see here. And you can see that there's too little number of tweets about hacktivism. And there's some word clouds, which words mostly used in those tweets. Of course, it's in Turkish. How can I say about hacktivists and hacktivism? There's no political word here. But there are some, for instance, the other one is very funny because there are some curse words here. I cannot translate it now.
Just fuck you.
Fuck. Anyway.
Be our guest, don't worry.
You guessed, okay, you guessed it. They just use curse words, but no politics. And most retweeted, 5 images. This is a book that writes about Red Hack, what is hacktivism. the description, definition of activism. These pages are about that. It's a book of a non-governmental organization in Turkey. And this one, Kurdistan, and these pages Hackett. This is mostly retweeted. And this one, the second one is about Berkin Elvan. Berkin Elvan is killed in those days, you know, the Gezi protests. And the first one is this. Their rights in Turkish. In English, if I please help me to translate. Can I get the crown after you?
Yeah, that's okay.
And this one is a professional actor who plays plays soap operas, and his role is about Süleyman the Magnificent. And the other one is, you know, the president. Anyway, so you can see that humor and curse words, but no politics again. But things change if you search for the word red hack. 1,345,000, nearly 1.5 million tweets about red hack, this hacktivist group. And the users who tweeted, individual users who tweeted for red hack is 457,000 individual users. If you compare this with the hacktivism and hacktivist, it says something. About Anonymous, 149,000 tweets about Anonymous. So Twitter users are interested in with this hacktivist, this international hacktivist group. They know, they informed about it. And nearly 70,000 users tweeted for Anonymous. And some hashtags for Red Hack, you can see in Turkish, of course, this Soma, President Erdogan, Otu is a university, there were some protests at that time. Barış Atay, another political profile. So in those tweets, in those hashtags, we can see some political senses, some political particles to discuss. Ankara, Anonymous. These are Berkin Elvan again. Gezi protests, about Gezi protests. That was all. So, in conclusion, what can we say about that? We can say that you have seen the general view of Twitter users in Turkey. Comparing this general view, the people who used the word hacktivist or hacktivism is very small in number. But if you search for specific examples, Red Hack and Anonymous, you can find some information. Okay, they know about hacktivism, they know about Red Hack, but they don't have any idea about hacktivism or hacktivist. They need some more information. We have to inform Twitter users or university educated people for what is hacktivism or hacktivists. They don't know, but they use it. I can say at the last. Okay, for this research to develop it, please don't hesitate to contact with me with those channels and write down your own ideas. How can I develop this research? How can I widen those questions? Thank you for listening. Any questions?
I don't know if you have data on it, but Twitter is always trending and you show different trends. Around the Giza protests, was there a lot more political activity on Twitter?
Yes, you're asking about the time limit?
Yeah, like around the Taksim Square Giza protests.
No,
this
it's
time.
A 1 year period. It's 1 year period. Before this day, they are very new. Information.
Did you see any change after your president blocked Twitter?
Yes. We couldn't see any change because Twitter was blocked.
Yeah, but that's nice.
So, yes, of course, people first showed some oppositional tweets, sent some oppositional tweets for some time, but after that they turned to those humorous tweets and those curse words tweets. So I mean the popular culture covered the agenda.
There's not much political talk, so I can imagine it's a bit because of the political climate here in Turkey that some things you're not supposed to talk about. Is there anything similar as what's happening in China that people rewrite words and use synonyms for controversial subjects in the discussions that maybe doesn't end up in your statistics?
Yeah, they don't talk about political subjects because they're scary. That's all. They're scary. And you know what? It was just about limited with Twitter. But tomorrow, Mr. Halit Polat will.
Some details. Tomorrow we have another presentation. Their activism point of view and perception about the social media, all of it. And also, I would like to add another point.
If you remember 10 years ago, we were doing my dissertation together, and at that time they even can't say hacker. What is hacker? They said something different, hedjar, or hedjar. Something else. They are just learning it nowadays.
Yes, my doctoral thesis is about Turkish internet hackers. I started my thesis in 2002 and I searched for some news stories in Turkish newspapers about hackers, and I find only three in 1 year at that time, only three news stories about hackers. But after that we have seen a lot of things in 10 years and internet and social media has become something that we would never imagine in Turkey. But now there are some, government is trying to regulate those free area, and some companies trying to capitalize those area, trying to make money, trying to make those areas a market, use it as a market, and it is a it's a hard situation because there were some legal issues about legal issues of people that who tweeted in the Gezi Park protests, so people are scared about tweeting with their own name. They use nicknames.
Another question, you say these topics are a bit scary, so I can imagine they must be even scarier to do research on. Do you feel you're limited in your research and what you can do, and how do you stand in this?
Yes. It's not very scary for me, but in my doctoral thesis I had some problems with writing some information on thesis, because you know, that many people read about it. My teachers warned me about some parts of my thesis. On those parts, I was talking about the relations between hackers and government, some relations with that, and with some relations about hackers and army. One of the hackers showed me a rifle that is given to him by Turkish army for thanking for his support. But I couldn't put them to my thesis because my, first of all, my teachers scared about it. It is not very easy to study on those subjects in Turkey.
I'd like to add another thing. Before this climate, also people were so they just began to learn these things, political terms, during the Gezi protest. And by the way, about there are two discourses. For example, you can define it as Gezi protests or Gezi. For example, if you write it in your dissertation or some other academic work, defining as Gezi protests or defining as Gezi resistance, because so if you say the word Gezi resistance, that means so.
One is, last time I was in Turkey, I was at a conference that was held by journalists, a European organization of journalists, and there was a report on the situation for journalists in Turkey, and it is very, very dangerous and dire. So I understand, you know, and I just want to salute you for your courage, and thank you for that.
We are the number one country jailing journalists.
Yes.
In the world.
And so being an activist or a hacker, you know, that takes quite a bit of courage, and the same with whistleblowers and so forth. Now, I just wanted to know if, because I've heard some very disturbing information about legal, you know, changes that are dangerous for activists and hacktivists and hackers and journalists and so forth. Is there anything we can do on any platform, you know, I as a lawmaker, for example, is there anything I can do to help, you know, to put pressure on your government?
Yeah. Pushing our government only scratches their back. They don't feel it, you know. But we try to awake people about some technical developments. But in Turkey, it's not very easy. The education level is not so high. For instance, a company, Form, named Form, company is helping technically to the government for our individual information, to get our individual information, private information, and nobody knows about this company in Turkey, the forum. That company was in States at the time, but the States put that company in front of the door some years ago. England did the same, but now they are in Turkey and they are illegally getting our private information. And now there is a legal case going on about form and its workings in Turkey. All we can do is try to find out some information and share with people, but it's not very easy. It's not very easy to get information, for instance, to get those information, to listen to Twitter, to get those information is for 5 years limit to get tweets to study is 30,000 euros. So my wage is nearly 1,500 euros. So it is not very easy to get those information. I got those information from the company Gonzo Insight. The owner of that company is my ex-student. So they gave me those information for me free. So I could share those information with you. I hope you like those information. I can do some more research on these data, but I need some questions. If you reach me through my email and and Facebook, I would love to develop my research. Yes. My brother from Bulgaria.
Yes. I wanted to ask you, because you already have all these different word bubbles.
Yes.
And you have information about the background, origin of the tweeting people, tweeters.
Evet.
So, have you tried to make some relation between those different categories and say, for example, people between this and this age buying cars or from Istanbul or from, I don't know, different, you know, features, properties of this person, use mostly these words, speak about this, react most quickly, retweeting and so on.
Yes, I could do that, but after seeing that word cloud, I decided not, because there was nothing significant in Turkish, just curse words, no political words, no agenda, there was nothing, you know. But it can be done.
Is there a requirement
in Turkey?
They are not so active.
I'm an academic, I'm not a pirate yet, but I would like to be. Not.
It's not registered yet.
Registered, yes.
Registered. Is it registered? Arif? The pirate part of Turkey. Is it registered?
Yeah. With this
pirate.
Now
you need academics.
Now you're officially part.
Thank you. Thank you. Any question? Okay.
I need to add something, if it's possible, about activism.
Yes.
I think I am still the first academic in Turkey who is teaching hacktivism in both undergraduate and graduate levels.
I've got some courses in the university, but it's really hard that to keep these courses alive, because even the in high level of the university, the, in master degrees, people don't want to choose this lesson. Last time I have got just only 5 students in master degree for that, in a class with 20 people. So I think it's still a scary topic for us,
course,
I guess.
The slogan of those kind of words is looking for trouble, you come to the right place.
Of course. But on the other hand, activism in Turkey, the reality of activism is, I think it's improving. But the government tools are improving also. I think there was a news which is about our government buy some kind of tool from Sweden. 10 points. So now censorship and surveillance thing is improving by the government, but also I think activism part, at least the digital activism part, is improving. But there is a funny thing that these social media users of the Turkey, when they got on Twitter, they are really brave about sharing some political things. But when it comes to reality, to the street, they suddenly keep themselves at their home. I think there are too many selectivists in Turkey for that. I can say that. But now we are going to improve our courses and also put some in other courses, maybe in some universities. Let's just hope we can make it. That's it.
Just a little hook for tomorrow. My assistant, Mr. Halil Polat, will do a presentation about why they don't use social media for political ends. They did. We did a focus group research and in-depth interviews with young Turks, and we tried to find the real answers. Hope to see you there again. And another question.
Yeah, I have a question following your commentary about the activism in Turkey. In Israel, I guess there isn't that much activism as well, but
I know, but
the reason I think may be different, because in Israel, which is so-called startup nation, and we have a lot of companies dealing with security, but they take the young, brilliant minds to the army, and then they are indoctrinated, and then they work for the government. So is it the same in Turkey?
Yes, same bullshit as in Turkey.
Okay.
And it's popular nowadays.
Going to army is a must for the men in Turkey, and
both
for women, I think, in Israel. Nowadays, some peoples, I think it's one of the effects of the resistance, some people are resisting to go there. So, this is popular nowadays.
Yeah.
Is there anyone? Common comment or questions? I think that's
it. Thank you all.
We thank you too. Anders.
Yeah, I was asked like 45 minutes ago to say bye for today.
I opened, you can't close.
So, what we're scheduled. Yeah, first of all, I would thank you, all of you, for participating today. It has been some really great speakers today, you have to admit that. And I guess tomorrow will be, it will be hard to top it, but it will at least be as good as it was today, tomorrow as well. Now we have scheduled 1 hour like social talk, and after that we are walking approximately 500 meters towards the city center, where we will buy or have dinner, and it will be free. If you want alcohol, you will have to pay for it yourself. So. Dinner, Hakan, it's approximately 7:30?
Yes. Yes.
7, yeah.
Sadrazam Kemal restaurant.
Okay, yeah, but we will walk in a yeah, group, so it won't be a problem. It's easy to find. Now, we have heard, I just want to mention that we have heard about hacktivists and activism in Turkey. I've worked as a family activist for 26 years now, and I can assure every single one here that even in countries like Norway, Sweden, countries where we assume that we have freedom and democracy, it's nothing close to it. The thing with Turkey is that it seems to be more difficult to hide it. In Norway and Sweden, it's easier to hide what we actually do to people that criticize our government. We have a research network, EU Kids Online. They will attend the IGF next week. I highly recommend the ones who are staying here to attend their sessions. And that's about how censorship on the internet affects the security for children, actually. It increases the risk for children getting bad experiences. And when we talk about activists, we have a couple of, one Nobel Prize winning economist and another economist at Harvard and the other at MIT who are actually pirates, but they are just not aware of it yet. And they are talking about the death of democracy. In their opinion, it doesn't exist anywhere in the world anymore. Next year we will try to get them to speak at this conference. We would really love it, and we would really love to see all of you here and a lot more people. And then I don't want to go through the list you went through when we opened, but we have to thank Arif, who did miracles to make this happen, his assistant Hakan, the vice or former vice rector John, and a bunch of other people who have helped us, the employees today. Yeah, exactly. I can't even remember all the names. So for now, I say thank you. Welcome back tomorrow. Now we have like social talks for an hour, 45 minutes an hour, and then we walk to the restaurant and have some fun.